Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 8th video class of DIP, we will study the basics of intensity transformations and spatial filtering and also its implementation in MATLAB. You know what is intensity transformations from our previous video classes? It is the changes in the grayscale values of the image. And spatial filtering means filtering operation on the image plane itself, or the space itself, or the x and y coordinates itself, right? So let us start. See, image enhancement is one of the very first steps in image processing. So as the name suggests, in this technique the original image is processed so that the resultant image is more suitable than the original for specific applications. That is, you can say the image is enhanced. See, image enhancement is a purely subjective processing technique. By subjective, we mean that the desired result varies from person to person. An image enhancement technique used to process images might be excellent for one person, but the same result might not be good for another person. It is also important to know at the outset that image enhancement is a cosmetic procedure. That is, it does not add any extra information to the original image. It only improves the subjective quality of the images by working with the existing data. Okay. So the image enhancement can be done in two domains, the spatial domain and the frequency domain. As the name suggests, the spatial domain is the enhancement of the image in the image plane itself, or image space itself, or the coordinate x and y plane itself, right? And the frequency domain process involves taking the Fourier transform of the image, doing the processing over there, and then taking the inverse Fourier transform and coming back to the image plane. The spatial domain techniques can be further classified into point processing and neighborhood processing. So as the name suggests, point processing means we are processing the image on a single point. So we will be processing image pixel by pixel or point by point for the whole image, and that is known as point processing. And as the name suggests, the neighborhood processing will be processing using a neighborhood of a pixel. For example, 3x3 neighborhood of a pixel, or a filter mask or window of a image will be used for processing the image. So the examples of point processing are image negative, contrast stretching, thresholding, etc., as we'll be seeing further. The neighborhood processing involves averaging filter, median filtering, etc. And some examples of frequency domain image enhancement is image sharpening using Gaussian high pass filters, unsharp masking, high boost filtering, etc. So in this video class, we'll be studying some of the point processing techniques, which we'll be carrying forward also in the next video class. So let us go ahead and understand the basics of intensity transformation and spatial filtering. So the spatial domain is simply the plane containing the pixels of the image. The spatial domain techniques operate directly on the pixels of an image, as opposed to the frequency domain, in which the operations are performed on the Fourier transform of an image rather than on the image itself. See, the spatial domain techniques are more efficient computationally and require less processing resources to implement. And the spatial domain processes can be denoted by the expression g of xy is equal to t of f of xy, where f of xy is our input image, g of xy is our output image, and t is an operator on f defined over a neighborhood of point x and y. So here we are moving the origin of the neighborhood from pixel to pixel and applying the operator t to the pixels in the neighborhood to yield the output at that particular location. Thus, for any specific location x and y, the value of the output image g at those coordinates is equal to the result of applying t to the neighborhood with an origin at xy in f. For example, suppose that the operator t is defined as compute the average intensity of the neighborhood. Then g of xy is computed as sum of f of xy and its 8 neighborhoods divided by 9, that is averaging the intensity of pixels. Okay, so if we carry out it here, then the origin of the neighborhood is then moved to the next location, and the procedure is repeated to generate the next value of output image g. Typically, the process starts at the top left of the input image and proceeds pixel by pixel in a horizontal scan, one row at a time. When the origin of the neighborhood is at the border of the image, part of neighborhood will reside outside the image. The procedure is either to ignore the outside neighbors in the computations specified by T or to pad the image with a border of zeros or some other specified intensity values. So this procedure is called spatial filtering. So this is a spatial filter, which is also referred to as spatial mask, kernel, template or window. So now from this, the smallest possible neighborhood is of size 1 cross 1. Here it is 3 cross 3. So the smallest possible neighborhood is of size 1 cross 1. In this case, G depends only on the value of F at a single point x and y, and T becomes an intensity transformation function of the form S is equal to T of R, where S and R are variables denoting respectively the intensity of G and F at any point x, y. So for example, if TR produce an image of higher contrast than the original by darkening the intensity levels below K and brightening the levels above K, the T function is called contrast stretching transformation function. So here the values of R lower than K are compressed by a transformation function into a narrow range of S towards black. The opposite is true for values of R higher than K. So this produces a high contrast image. Similarly, this one produces a two-level binary image where values of K higher than R are high values or 1 and lower than K are 0 values or black. So mapping of this form is called a thresholding transformation function. So these techniques are also called point processing techniques as opposed to neighborhood processing techniques. Why? Because we are operating on a single point x and y, whereas for neighborhood processing techniques, as we will learn further, we'll be operating on some neighbor of some particular size using a kernel or a window as shown here. So here we have applied contrast stretching on this particular image, which is a very washed out type image, and after applying contrast stretching, the image becomes a high contrast image like this. Similarly, to this original image, we have applied a thresholding function like this, and hence it will be having only two values, that is 1 and 0. So you can see here, out of number of gray levels, it is only having two values, that is black and white. So let us perform these functions in MATLAB. So this program shows MATLAB code for contrast stretching. We are reading an image and we are converting the color image into grayscale image by using RGB to gray command. Now to make this image a washed out image, I am adding intensity levels of 100 to each and every pixel of the image by using imadd i, 100. I is our original image and we are adding 100 intensity levels to each and every pixel so that the image will become washed out or very bright. Next, we'll be adjusting the contrast in the image by using the stretch limb function of MATLAB. This stretch limb works by contrast stretching the image by saturating the upper and the lower limits of contrast. So by default, the values are 0.01, 0.99. So it will be here saturating the upper 1% and lower 1% of the intensity values. Okay, so these are lower 1% values and these are upper 1% values. So I'll be showing both the images side by side, our washed out image, that is 100 intensity added image, and the contrast stretch image. So let us run this program and see the output. So see, this is our original image and this is contrast stretch image. You can see the original image is a very bright image, a washed out image, that is contrast stretch using the stretch limb function. So let us change the values of this stretch limb function and see what happens. We are changing this value from 0.99 to 0.09, that is near to 0.1, and see what happens. So you can see here that the image has become much darker. Why? Because we have decreased the higher values or brighter values, and therefore it has become dark. On the contrary, let us increase this value from 0.01 2.90, and let us run the program and see the output. So it has become much brighter image. Why? Because we have increased the dark values, which are from 0.01 to 0.90. That means we have gone towards brighter side, and therefore the image has become brighter, as you can see in this image. So that is how we use the contrast stretching function in MATLAB. Let us go ahead. So this program shows different point processing techniques. Initially, I am reading an image and converting this image I0 into grayscale image by using RGB to gray command. And then I am displaying both the color image and grayscale image side by side by using montage command. You can also use the inbuilt cameraman.tiff image of MATLAB. Let us run this portion, this section first. So this is my original color image that is converted into a grayscale image. Let us go ahead to the next section and perform image thresholding. Thresholding means thresholding between two values, zeros and one. That means it is a binary image, right? So I'll be using inbuilt MATLAB command imbinarize for binarizing the grayscale image that we have, and then I'll be displaying both the grayscale image and the binary or threshold image side by side. Let us run this section. So you can see here, this is our original image and this is the binary image or the threshold image that we are obtaining, that is having only two values, black and that is 0 and white that is 1. Let us go ahead to the next section and see what we are doing here. So here we are adding some intensity levels to the original image. Whenever we want to perform arithmetic operations on image directly without using the MATLAB commands, we have to convert that particular image into double by using double command. Then after creating this image, I'll be adding intensity values 100 to each and every pixel of the image, which is my ID1 image, and then I'll be displaying my original image and ID1 image side by side by using montage command. And remember, whenever you have double converted an image and you want to display it, you have to bring it back to original image by using uint8, that is unsigned integer 8. So you have to write unsigned integer 8 of ID1, and this will display our original image and the intensity added image. Let us run this section and see what happens. So this is our original image and this is our intensity added image. That means we have added 100 intensity to each and every pixel of the image, and the image has become a very bright image or a washed out image. Let us change the values of addition from 100 to say 200. So again the image will become more brighter, as you can see here. And if you add 255, that is the maximum value, and run the section, you will see that the image becomes complete white. Why? Because you have added white value to each and every intensity. So now the image will be only a white image like this. And conversely, if you add -255, then obviously the output image will be a complete dark image like this. Let us bring it back to original 100 value. Now see, here we are applying arithmetic operation to the image, but rather than this, you can also use inbuilt image add function of the MATLAB. So I will be disabling these all lines and I will enable this line, ID1, montage and title. So what I am doing here, also I am adding 100 intensity value, but I am using imadd function of the MATLAB. And now when you are using imadd function, you need not convert the image into double image by using the double command, and you need not use the unsigned integer 8 command while displaying the image. Okay, you can directly display the image. Let us run the program and see this particular section output. So again, the intensity added image will be same. So you can use either the arithmetic operation on the image, and you can also use the inbuilt MATLAB command, which is more feasible to use. Let us go ahead and see what happens if we subtract the intensity levels from the image. So ID2 is ID minus 50. See, again, the image is converted into double. ID is my double image, right? Which is already double. And what I'll be doing, I'll be subtracting 50 intensity values from this double image. So of course, subtraction we have also seen earlier by making the image complete dark. Then I'll be displaying the original image I and the subtracted intensity value image. Whenever I have to display it, I have to convert into unsigned integer 8. So let us run this section and see what happens. So you can see the image has become darker by subtracting 50 intensity value from each and every pixel. So this image add and image subtract can also be used for displaying two images together, or adding two images together, or subtracting two images. So now let us disable this section and enable these lines, which will be using directly inbuilt MATLAB command im subtract rather than subtracting the value arithmetically. So I can use im subtract I 30 rather than 30. Let us use 50 as it was used earlier, and then I can directly display it without using unsigned integer. So let us run this section and see the output. The output is same. If you change it to 30, the image will be less dark. If you change to 10, further the image will be less dark, as you can see here. And of course, if you use 255, that means your image will become complete dark like this. So this is how you can use im subtract function. Let us see what happens when we multiply the intensity levels to some particular image. So here I am using im multiply inbuilt function of MATLAB, and I am multiplying each and every intensity value by 0.3, which is nearer to 0. So as it is nearer to 0, that means the image will become dark, and I'll be displaying the image. Let us see how the image looks. Of course, the image has become darker as you are multiplying nearer to 0 values. If you change the values from 0.3 to say 0.1, the image will become still dark, as you can see in the output. Let us go ahead and see what will happen when we divide intensity levels to the image. So obviously, division will be opposite of multiplication. So here, for multiplication, when we were multiplying by nearby 0 values, the image was darker. But here, when we'll be dividing by nearby 0 values, the image should become brighter. So I am using im divide function, and I am dividing each and every intensity value by 0.03. That means the intensity value will become brighter. So let us run this particular portion, and you can see, and in fact you can see in the image, that the eyes are extracted from the image. So these results are very interesting. Why? Because using such functions, you can even extract some of the particular portions such as hair, eyes, etc. of the image. Let us change this value from 0.03 to 0.01. So the again the image will become more brighter, as you can see here. Now even the eyes are not visible. And if you are increasing it to 10, the image will be brighter, of course, but more visible as compared to the earlier values. So this is how you can perform different point processing techniques on the image. So that is all for this video class. We will learn about more point processing techniques in the next video class of DIP. Thank you very much.